Welcome to this class of artificial intelligence. Presently we are discussing fuzzy sets. In this class we will see that how to represent fuzzy sets. If a given fuzzy set is there, then how to write that fuzzy set in terms of its membership functions. We know that in classical or crisp sets, the transition of an element in the universe between membership and non-membership in a given set is abrupt and well defined, and that is said to be crisp. And for an element in a universe that contains fuzzy sets, this transition can be gradual. Hence, membership of an element from the universe in this set, which is fuzzy set, in this set is measured by a function, and this function attempts to describe vagueness and ambiguity. So we can say that elements of a fuzzy set, this one fuzzy set, are mapped to a universe of membership values. And this we do using a function theoretic form. Now here I will introduce a notation for representing fuzzy sets so that any confusion from the representation given in conventional set or crisp set is avoided. So what we do whenever we specify a fuzzy set, we put a tilde under strike. So here if I write like this, tilde under strike, it means that it is a fuzzy set A. Fuzzy set A. If an element in the universe, say X, is a member of fuzzy set A, here we represent it using this one. So if an element in the universe, that is for example X, is a member of fuzzy set A, this set, then this mapping is given by, normally is given by mu, this symbol is used, mu A, and tilde is used to represent fuzzy set, and we get values in the range 0 to 1, that two real numbered values. So we can say that this mu A X, which we get as membership value corresponding to X, gives values between 0 to 1. This mapping is shown in this figure here for a typical fuzzy set. So this is a fuzzy set and these are on Y axis, whatever you are getting is a membership value, and on this axis X, you are getting the element in the as a set A. Now we will come to the notations. So a notation convention for fuzzy sets: when the universe of discourse X is discrete and finite, is as follows for a fuzzy set or any general fuzzy set A tilde, and just try. And so on. And this can also be written in this form: summation over I mu A tilde X I for X I. And when the universe of discourse X is continuous and finite, then the fuzzy set A is denoted by mu A tilde X for X. In both the notations, the horizontal bar, this bar here and this bar, is not a quotient. These two bars are not a quotient, but rather a delimiter. It's a delimiter. The numerator means numerator here and numerator here in each term is the membership value. This is a membership value in set A. This is a membership value in this set A associated with the element of the universe, this or this, indicated in the denominator. In the first notation, this one, the summation symbol is not for algebraic summation. This is not for algebraic summation, but rather denotes the collection or aggregation of each element, like this, this. Aggregation of such elements are represented by this, where each element here indicates that this is a membership function corresponding to element x1. This is the membership function corresponding to element x2. But these are not quotients. These are not quotients. These are, this is, this horizontal line is simply delimiter. We are writing two things simultaneously, taking the help of this delimiter. So it's not for division. Hence, this plus sign in the first, this notation, these signs are not the algebraic add. These are not algebraic add. No, not like that. But are function theoretic union. And in the second notation here, in this notation, this integral sign is not an algebraic integral. All algebraic, I mean, it's not intending integration, but it is a continuous function theoretic union for continuous values, continuous variables. So now we can say that this representation which is given here is for that. These membership values are plotted here and these are continuous. So here you can see that here we are not writing xi, we are not writing x1, x2 in this form, because this x is continuous. And for discrete case, discrete and finite, we will go here. You will see that the values here, these are finite values, discrete values, and they will be finite in number, and their corresponding mu values are on y-axis. So these are discrete values of membership functions. But if we go here, then we see that in any period of x, there are infinite number of points. When we are going to take x continuous, So in fact, here we cannot write finite. Here it will be infinite whenever we are going for continuous. Now we will take an example for fuzzy sets. So let us take a fuzzy set A and suppose members of the universe of discourse are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we know that the corresponding membership values are 0.3, 0.4, 0.6, 0.7, 0.9, or so. Now let us assume that this represents some specific situation from the real life time or real life situation. So for example, this may be a set of persons who are having height close to 5 feet, close to not 5 feet, rather 6 feet. So this is a set of such persons. So here we can say that person who is having height 1 foot is certainly having this grade of membership in this fuzzy set very low. So that's why suppose we take 0.3. A person having height as 2 feet will certainly be having membership value higher than this one, but not much higher, so 0.4. And as we discussed earlier, all these are perceptional. So it depends that how someone is perceiving it. Then third person having height 3 feet, he may be assigned a membership value 0.6. And the fellow having 4 feet is very close to 5, 6 feet. So he may get higher membership values. And a person having 5 feet may be 0.9. And we can rather extend this set also. And suppose we take that a person of height 6 feet is there, then his membership value will be 1. Grade of membership will be 1. Because his closeness to 6 feet is perfect. So in this way we will be representing a fuzzy set. And as these are going to be a collection of these individual elements and corresponding membership functions, so we will be writing plus, which is nothing but union. So here these we call singleton. So these two singletons are given to us and we are going to combine them, aggregate them and make a set of two elements. So it's a union. Now in this set we add a third member with its corresponding membership function. So we get a new set of three members. So this we get by getting the union. In this way, we keep on adding members, singletons, and using this union operation. Now, suppose we take another set, which is B, and we'll be using this tilde and strike. And suppose we say that it represents a set of those who have their height close to 3 feet. Now, obviously, you can say that this person who is having height 3 feet will be having 100% closeness to 3 feet. So, we will be assigning it a membership value 1. But what about the person having a 4 feet height? So, as this 4 feet is not exactly 3 feet, but it is close to 3 feet. What about person having height at 5 feet or having height 6 feet? So this 4 is much closer to 3 as compared to 5. And this 5 is closer as compared to 6. So the membership value to the closer entity will be higher. So suppose we assign 0.8, and to this we may assign 0.7, and to this we may assign 0.5. Similar is the case when we take persons having lesser heights. So this 2-foot fellow is close to 3, so we may also assign it at 0.8. This 1-foot fellow is also close to 3 feet, but not that close as 2-foot high person. So this will be having lower this membership value, and suppose it is going to be 0.6. Now here you can notice that I am giving a different value to this as compared to this. Whereas this, if you see the difference between these two, between these 1 and 3 and between 1 and 5, it is 2 feet. But based on the perception, one may assign 0.6 to 1 and 0.7 to 5. Now here we may think of some fuzzy set operations. Suppose union. We want to take union, which will be mu, and want to get membership values for the elements in union. So we can write membership value mu for this set A union B, or any element in this set can be written, as we discussed earlier, that membership of this X, element X, in this element A, this fuzzy set A, and this connective is there for max in our case, and membership value of the same X in fuzzy set B. So using this fuzzy set operation, we can find the union for these two sets A and B, and that will be we can write A union B as, with the help of this formula, we can evaluate the union of using this membership function or membership values. So this X is equal to 1, and this X is also equal to 1. So for this 1, these mu X values are 0.3, and this mu X value or membership value is 0.6. Then max of these two is going to be 0.6 for this element 1. And here if we take this one and this one, then max is going to be this. So 0.8 divided by 2. Here I am telling divided by 2, but it's not actually divided by 2. You can say that membership value 0.8 for the element 2. And here it is 1. Max out of these two is 1. So 1 by 3. And similarly for the member 4, it will be 0.8. And here for the person having height 5 feet, this will be the maximum. So we will get 0.9. And the person with 6 feet, we will get maximum value here. So we will assign it to 1. And this will be the fuzzy set A union B in terms of membership values corresponding to each of the members. Now we should see that what is the interpretation of this fuzzy set in this particular case, where we are taking case A, means fuzzy set A, for members which are close to 6 feet and assigning membership values accordingly. And whereas B is going to take the grade of membership depending upon this property, close to 3 feet. So this is based on close to 6 feet and this is close to 3 feet. Then what the interpretation should be given in sentence form combining these two sentences or these two descriptions. So the description in case of union is going to be like this. So a person, an element X, I will call a person X in this set, union set, is either close to 6 feet or close to 3 feet. So now we have a combined sentence that this is, we can call it C. So this is a fuzzy set of members who are either close to 6 feet or close to 3 feet, and based on this description, their membership values are assigned. So person having 1 feet height is going to have closeness to 3 feet higher as compared to 6 feet. So he is getting this membership 0.6, because that he is this much higher closeness, or higher, he is satisfying this term more as compared to this term. So we give this membership value. Similarly, we can take this case. So person of 3 feet height is either close to 3 feet or close to 6 feet. So one of this is he is fully satisfying, which is this one. Person having height 3 feet is of height 3 feet. So he is having 100% grade of membership in this union. So we will assign it 1. Similarly, we can evaluate for other members also, and in whichever of these two they are having higher membership values, they will be assigned to that. Now let us see that how to get complement of this given set. So its complement, as we know, will be 1 minus this membership value for this complement. Here it means complement is equal to 1 minus mu a tilde x. This is what we have seen in the previous lecture. So using this membership property, here we can very easily write the membership values for all these members. And here it means that height is not close to 6 feet. So we are measuring this property. How much is this satisfied? So here it is 1 minus 0.3, so it becomes 0.7. So this is the grade of membership, 0.7, when this property we are looking for not close to 6. So it is 0.7 membership when we want to say about the person having height 1 feet. He is 0.7 or 70% not close to 6. Then this fellow is 0.6, not close to 6 feet. Here it will be 0.4. Here it will be 0.3. Here it will be 0.1. And here it will be 0. So this 0 means that we are taking this reference closeness to 6 feet and not close to 6 feet. So 6 feet person is definitely not close to 6 feet. Hence, we are going to take 0 as per the definition, and then these are going to be function theoretic unions of these singletons. Now, here we are going to see an interesting property in case of fuzzy set, that if we take a crisp sets, suppose let us take a crisp set C is given, and we are going to take union of this set with its complement. Then in case of crisp set, is this going to be universe of discourse? And similarly, if we go for C and its intersection with its complement, then it is going to be null set. So when we say universe of discourse is the result, then it means that all the members are having their membership value 1. Here all the members in this set, in this resulting set are going to have membership values 0. Now let us see that what happens in this case. So if you go for A tilde union A tilde bar means its complement, then what values you will get? So union means we will be going for max of these two. So max gives us 0.7. Here max gives us 0.6. Similarly 0.6. Here 0.7. Here 0.9. And here 1. Now this is for element 1, element 2, element 3, person having height 4, 5 and 6. So here what you get is not universe of discourse. Universe of discourse means that all these values should be 1. This should be 1, this should be 1, this should be 1, should be 1, this should be 1, this is already 1. Then it will be universe of discourse. But in case of fuzzy set, we find that A union A complement is not giving universe of discourse. So in case of fuzzy sets, we write, this is the property in case of fuzzy set, that A union A complement A is not equal to X. Whereas in case of conventional set or crisp set, a set having its union with its complement is going to be a universe of discourse. Similarly, you can do this for this fuzzy set. For this same fuzzy set, you can verify that its intersection with its complement is not equal to null set.